Hello everyone. Today we are going to deal with the actuator part in the mechatronic system. Basically, actuators will incorporate like different systems like pneumatic systems, hydraulic systems, switches, motors, electric motors, likewise. So we will be dealing with pneumatic systems in this section today. So basically, contents of this video are about automation, about pneumatics applications, advantages and disadvantages, pneumatic standards, classification of pneumatic elements, applications of air cylinders, components of pneumatics, comparison between pneumatic, electro-pneumatic and PLC based control systems, air pressure losses, malfunctions of pneumatic systems, general safety measures and basic pneumatic circuits. So what is automation? Automation is basically the delegation of human control function to technical equipment for increasing productivity, increasing quality, reducing cost, increasing safety in working condition. So here application of that automation is shown in this picture. So industrial robots. So what are these robots doing? These robots are involved in the assembly line of an automobile. You can see here different functions like welding, spray painting, then windshield fitting are done with the help of robotic arms. No human involvement is seen here. Then automated guided vehicles. We know we need to carry different jobs, components, different sub-assemblies from one station to the another station in an automation line or industry. So instead of using human labor, we can go for this automated guided vehicle. Those will follow the particular path and those vehicles can deliver different jobs or components or different small elements required in assembly from one station to the another station without human intervention or without use of human, and again for longer durations. Then CNC machine. Basically all mechanical engineers are very well aware with this machine. So computer numerical control machine, we need to go for a computer numerical control for high quality end products or machined products. Then automation in electronics industry, we can see here. So basically in electronic industry, what is done here? We can see here one PCB on which some electronic components are going being installed. So all these shooters you can see here are nothing but pneumatically controlled valves, and these are components which we need to fit on the PCBs. Like here you can see one integrated circuit is shown here, like it may be some microprocessor. Then these are the MOSFETs, these are LEDs, likewise very small elements, these are diodes. Very small elements are to be placed on a particular place on a PCB with high accuracy. For that, this pneumatic control suckers are used. Then again we are aware with the hydraulic system in automobile. So here you can see the automobile with hydraulic fittings, and that how that all hydraulic works, that is also shown in the small magnified picture here. So basically in nowadays in automobiles there are a lot of hydraulic systems are used. Hydraulic braking or pneumatic braking is there. Then hydraulic steerings are there. Then window glass also is hydraulically operated. So again, a larger vehicles, heavy vehicles use definitely use air brakes, that means pneumatically operated brakes. So basically we'll be going for the classification now. So in industrial automation we can go for pneumatics or hydraulics or electrical and electronics. So in general automation in industries are classified into these three categories. Out of the above three, pneumatic systems are used in achieving low cost automation in industries. So why to go for pneumatics? It is a low cost application to reduce the labor cost, to reduce machine investment cost, to increase productivity and to reduce human efforts. Is these are advantages of automation, and pneumatic automation is achievable in low cost compared with hydraulics and electronics. So we will be going through this pneumatic automation from the coming slides. So what is pneumatics? In Greek, pneuma means air. Study or subject dealing with pneuma or compressed air is called as a pneumatics. Product that uses compressed air as a medium of operation is called as a pneumatic components. Again, mechanisms which use air pressure to apply mechanical force or displacement work. Or the pneumatic devices we use are basically binary actuators, either retracted or extended. So in this picture you can see this is the retractor cylinder and this is the extended cylinder. So basically this cylinder, it may be a single acting cylinder or a double acting cylinder, is used to convert compressed air for energy in compressed air as a mechanical displacement energy. So this cylinder rod can be extracted or extended or retracted according to our requirement, so it can give the displacement to the work as per the our requirements. So low cost automation, pneumatics is widely used by small and medium scale industries for implementing low cost automation to reduce machine investment cost, to reduce the pressure time, the process time, to increase the productivity and to have consistent quality. These are the advantages of low cost automation. Again, advantages and limitations of pneumatics. Advantages: it is simple, easy to control, can apply a lot force from a small light package. Force is limited by air pressure and cylinder diameter. The speeds and forces are infinitely variable. So these are advantages. Again, continued. Pneumatic tools where when overloaded will stop and so safe as compared to electrical systems. No fire hazard as in electrical systems, so can be easily used in dangerous areas like mines. Simple in construction, the pneumatic system components are easy to maintain and repair. The used air is exhausted, so no return line is in pneumatic system as those are in hydraulic systems. That is again advantage. There are also fewer disadvantages, that is smooth and uniform speeds against loads are not achievable as in hydraulic systems. Beyond certain load uses of pneumatic system, it is expensive. These are basically two main disadvantages. Then form of output: linear motion or rotary motion or semi-rotary motion. These three forms can be achieved from the pneumatic system. Applications: pneumatic equipments can be used for applications where operation cycles need certain routine functions like pushing, pulling, lifting, feeding, clamping, pressing or forming. These are different applications. Again, application areas: air brakes of automobile and trains, as we have discussed. Then air engine, pneumatic drills, pneumatic press, power press, motional for assembly lines like automobile industry or packaging or bottling, pneumatic vehicle cleaning, anti-aircraft weapon, pneumatic launchers, vacuum pump, pressure regulator, cotton mills, dairies, forge shops, foundries, metal forming, paper mills, printing, then so on and so on. Very large list is there. So these are few application areas of pneumatic systems. Okay, then applications of pneumatic system. See here, in this picture we can see a pneumatic drill machine. So a man is operating a pneumatic drill for breaking the rock. Okay. Then this is again pneumatic suction machine. So this machine is handling a large glass by using suction cups which are mounted at the very end of the pneumatic arm. So this is also one kind of application, pneumatic suction. Then pneumatic wrench, many of you may have seen this. We can see it in a Formula One race when they replace the tires very quickly. So their pneumatic wrench is used. This can be used for the rotary motion and so clamping and declamping or tightening or loosening of a bolt can be possible by using this pneumatic wrench. Okay. Then pneumatic conveyor system in automation industry, you can see here in the conveyor there are a lot of components are moving. Pneumatic adjustable table, so the height can be adjusted by using a compressed air. So this is the cylinder. Again, this rod can be extended or retracted accordingly. The height of the table is adjusted, and these are the pneumatic lines. And here there is a components, different components like direction control valve, then a parallel unit, etc., etc. And pedal operated system can be seen. Pneumatic jack, we know we need jack for lifting the vehicle for replacing the tire. So this is again a pneumatic jack. Pneumatic brake, here it is the graphical representation of a pneumatic brake is shown. So this is the wheel and this is the brake shoe, and this is connected to the cylinder. We can say it is a brake cylinder. Again, it is a single acting cylinder, so it has a spring. So it is piston. As we are going to apply the brake, the compressed air is sent to the cylinder, and because of that, this cylinder rod is extended, which again presses the brake shoe against the wheel rim, and brake is applied. So different color coding is shown here to show the different conditions of air in the system. Pneumatic clamping, so for clamping of components we can use again pneumatic systems. Again, pushing the parts from the conveyor and fixing the parts. So here a pneumatic clamping, declamping, so this part is fixed in the fixture by applying pneumatic force for the drilling at the required point. Here again there are different pneumatic cylinders are used so that this part can be moved on a conveyor. Okay. So applications: part detection, press fitting, clamping the parts, etc. These are the applications shown here. A double acting cylinder is used for embossing slide rules. So here it is a double acting cylinder, this is a slide rule, and this is embossing this rule by using a double acting cylinder. So this part will come, again press here, and again it will go back. So double acting cylinder is there. So direction of movement is shown in this picture. Then again pins are to be fed to the next processing station using a double acting cylinder. Again a double acting cylinder is used. So direction will be like this. So these small components, so it will be one by one press, and this component will go from this opening towards the next operation. So this will move in horizontal direction, pressing one after another component as required in the next station. Pneumatically controlled press with the stamping die again. So here it is acting as a lever, so this cylinder will extend and retract in vertical direction. Accordingly, this stamping die will come on the badge and again go in the upward direction, and the badge is stamped. Arrangement of pushing workpiece. Okay, as we see in the last operation, this is also the same operation. Then small riveting machine with the lever, again the same as the stamping like operation is also same here. An application using a toggle, again same. Then workpiece clamping in hacksaw cutting machine. Again, workpiece clamping. This is the hacksaw cutting machine here. So this is the saw tooth, and this clamping and declamping is carried out with the help of this pneumatic cylinder. So this rod is extended, and this bar, which is a rectangular cross-sectional bar, is fixed in a hacksaw table. Pneumatic injection in a plunger type molding machine. So again, this is a plunger type molding machine. Again, here you can see a pneumatic cylinder which is pressing the raw material through this injector in this mold cavity. Again, this is cavity is clamped by using another cylinder. Then a leak test automated using pneumatic cylinders. So for leak test, so by using these two pneumatic cylinders, so firstly this cylinder will clamp this component on this platform, and again this cylinder will extend to submerge that component in the water tank, and leak test is performed. Then endurance test of a spring done using pneumatic cylinders. So again, this is the spring mounted here, and by using pneumatic cylinders we can carry out the endurance test. Door opening and closing mechanism using air cylinder. Again, here you can see door opening and closing by using pneumatic cylinder. Punching operation on a thin sheet with air cylinder, we can see here. Pneumatic cylinders used for automation and drilling machine. Again, pneumatic drilling is also possible. So we can see here the components. So this is pneumatically operated cylinder is there. So here rack and pin arrangement, and you, based on this, this drill will move. Again, for clamping, again another cylinder is used. Pneumatic cylinder is used for line feeding automation. These are few pneumatic standards. ISO standards are given here. I am not going to read. You can go through it one by one. Then classification of pneumatic elements. Different elements which are there in the system. The pneumatic elements are classified into five groups. As we will go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Five is working element, which is air cylinder. So you can again see here. This is the working element, which is a air cylinder or a pneumatic cylinder. It may be a single acting or a double acting. Then final control elements, so flow control valve or quick exhaust valve. You can see here the symbolic representation. Control elements, which are direction control valves. This is a direction control valve, like solenoid operated, pilot operated, etc. Then signal elements, so these are push button valves or roller lever valves. So these are the signal elements. Then very first, that is source and service element, that is compressor and reservoir and FRL unit. This is the FRL unit is service element. So these are the components shown in this basically. So these are the five groups in which we can classify pneumatic elements. So first, that is source and service elements, that is air, then compressor, air filter, air pressure regulator, air lubricator, air service unit, and pneumatic silencer. These are the components which come under the first group, that is source and service elements. So air, that is the earth is surrounded by an envelope of an air which is known as atmosphere. The composition of this is a 12 mile thick envelope. Due to the compressibility of air, increasing the pressure causes decrease in the volume of the air. Okay, that is PV is equal to C, that is Boyle's law. Pressure measurement, we know this. Then compressors. A compressor is a machine that compresses air to or another type of gas from a low inlet pressure, usually atmospheric, to a higher desired pressure level. This is accomplished by reducing the volume of the gas. Air compressors are generally positive displacement units and are either of the reciprocating piston type or a rotary screw or rotary vane type. Graphical symbol of compressor is also shown here. Okay. Then types of compressor, that is piston compressor. In this type of the compressor, a cylinder bore encloses a moving piston as a crankshaft of the compressor. rotate, the piston moves within the cylinder, similar to the piston in a car engine. As a piston is pulled down, the volume increases, creating a lower atmospheric pressure in the piston chamber. This difference in pressure causes air to enter via inlet valve. As the piston is forced upwards, the volume of air is reduced and the air pressure therefore increases. Eventually, the pressure forces outlet valve to open. So, it is a piston compressor, means a reciprocating type compressor is there. Then, vane compressor. So, graphical representation of vane compression is shown here. Okay, so it is a sliding vane type rotary compressor. The air inlet is placed where the volume of the compressor chamber is greatest, the outlet where the volume is smallest. Consequently, the vane turns, the space between them is reduced. The reduction in volume compresses the air and as it travels from the inlet to outlet. Then this is the screw compressor. Okay, lobe type compressor. Compressor specifications are shown in this slide. So okay, so what are the different specifications can be seen here. Then the next component, that is air filter. The air needs to be filtered free from moisture and contamination. Air filter is used to do the job. The filter elements remove the particles and moisture as small as 5 microns. Normally 30 to 50 micron filter is used in pneumatic system. So picture as well as cut section as well as symbol are shown in this slide. Then air pressure regulator. So again, pictorial view, the photo, then cut section, and a symbol is also shown here. The pressure regulator is used to adjust the desired pressure for the pneumatic system. This uses a piston to sense downstream pressure fluctuations. The piston in turn works against a set of spring pressure. As the pressure downstream drops, it is sensed by the diaphragm and the puppet valve opens. This adjusts the position of the puppet valve, which limits the downstream pressure of the preset valve. Then air lubricator. Lubricator ensures proper lubrication of internal moving parts of pneumatic systems. The proportional increase in oil mist by an increase of air flow is achieved by the spring loaded puppet assembly. As the flow increases and the valve opens, the area is increased and the pressure difference is created. So again, a photo of a lubricator, cut section view, and symbol, graphical symbol is also shown here. So this is air service unit. The filters, regulators, and lubricants can combine to ensure optimum compressed air preparation for the specific pneumatic system. And so it is called as a FRL unit, or filter, regulator, lubricator unit, service unit. And all the components are shown here. Then pneumatic silencer. To decrease the noise of the air in the outlet of the valves, the silencer can be used. They are made from a porous plastic or bronze. Some of them are equipped with the control flow valve to control velocity of the flow in the outlet of the valves as well. So again, photos and graphical symbol are shown. So that was regarding the first group. Then the second, then signal elements. So different elements are shown here, manually operated, general manual, push button, pull button, push pull button, levers, pedals, treadle, and rotary knob. These are different representation are shown here. Again, plungers, spring normally returned, roller, unidirection or way trip, pressure, pilot pressure, differential pressure, detent in three positions. Then electrically operated, solenoid direct, solenoid pilot with manual override and integral pilot supply, solenoid pilot with manual override and external pilot supply. When no integral or external pilot supply is shown, it is assumed to be integral. Next, that is direction control elements, the third group. So we can see these different direction control valves, 2x2 direction control valve, 3x2, 4x2, 5x2 or 5x3 direction control. So these are different direction control valves. So basically a valve is named as the in the following order: number of positions and number of ports. So number of positions, 2 positions or 3 positions. Graphical symbol is shown here again, 2 or 3 positions. So number of positions and number of ports. So 2 ports, see symbol, 3 ports. Then 4 ports and 5 ports. So these are number of ports. Then how the direction control valve is represented is shown in this slide. Okay, so exhaust ports are there, pressure ports are there, working ports are there, and the lines which are switching between these ports. So here we can see a 2x2 direction control valve. Basic valve before operators are added, function 2x2. Examples, push button operated with spring return. So normal position. So you can see here how the 2x2 direction control valve is used. So basically it is used for a single acting cylinder, pneumatic cylinder. Okay. So this is in operated position. Okay. So this is normal position. This is in operated condition. See here now, here as it is in normal condition, there is a no flow, and when we actuate this valve, the flow starts from the upper lid to the cylinder. Okay, and as the flow starts, the piston gets extended, piston rod gets extended. Then 3x2 direction control valve, here it is the position 3x2, it is the normal position. Okay, and this is operated position. See here, in normal position, what happens? There is no compressed air present in the cylinder, as there is no connection. Okay, or rather this is connected to the drain. As we can see here, all the, then here as we want to change the position, this get connected to the cylinder and compressed air is filled inside the cylinder and this rod gets extended. Then 4x2, same case. See here, this is a normal position, so it is returning. And this is actuated or operated position, it is extended. 5x2, this is normal position, extracted, operated position, extended. Okay, so 5x3 direction control valve, three position valves have a normal central position that is set by springs or with a manual control such as lever. The flow pattern in the center position varies with the type. Three types will be considered: valve port seal, outlet to exhaust supply seal, and supply to both outlets exhaust seal. These are the three positions. This is 5x3 direction control valve. So different three types and their symbolic representation are shown. Okay, operated position, normal position, second operated position. Okay, now the fourth, that is final control elements, the fourth group. So here it is, flow control, different flow control valves. So it is a throttle valve as shown here with a graphical symbol of a throttle valve. Then check valve or a non-return valve, graphical symbol is shown here. So this is open condition, this is closed condition. So flow is will be only in one direction, no reverse flow is possible. As we can see here, because of the pressure, this disc moves and it allows the flow like this side towards the one direction when it is open. This disc moves against this spring force because of the pressure of this coming fluid. Okay, and in here see, this spring, because of the spring force, this disc moves and it blocks, it sits on the seats available and it blocks the passage. So there will not be any return flow. So this is called as a non-return valve. One way flow control valve. Okay, so we need again to ensure that the same condition. Then quick exhaust valve, this is the graphical symbol, and cut section view. Okay, so in this video we'll be stopping here. The logic valves we'll study in again next video.